National Science and Math Quiz is one of the most important, if not the most important show in Ghanaian TV history. This show has been one of the main players contributing to the increasing number of students pursuing science and math courses in high school and beyond. But over its long 31-year run, the show has had its fair share of criticisms, especially that it only focuses on theory and the accumulation of a lot of book knowledge. Other people have also said it does no actual good for the country and it's just a waste of time. So recently, in a widely publicized video, one such opinion was shared by a young lady from Nsein Senior High School. It blew up on the internet and people have been going crazy about it. When I first saw this on my timeline, you should follow me on Twitter by the way, I made a comment on that post and it went wild. So if you are one of those people or you are new here, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Francis and in this video, we are going to be discussing everything I found wrong with that video. So I'd like to start this video by giving some information about the categorizations of senior high schools in Ghana. So in Ghana, senior high schools are grouped into four categories: the Group A, Group B, Group C, and Group D. With Group A having the most facilities, being the best in terms of academic performance, and they also often have the best teachers and staff. The Category B schools are also quite good, but not as good as Category A. They have limited resources and less facilities.
Look at the infrastructure.
Category C and D have very limited resources as compared to the A and B. Representing Category A, we have Presbyterian Boys Secondary School, and Category B, Nsein Senior High School.
I tell people that I am a student of Nsein Senior High School. They say, what school is that? It's not popular. We've not seen it in science and math quiz. Why?
The Science and Math Quiz is a show, my school, and it's not for show.
Indeed, she's right. I've already called it a show several times in this video, and quite honestly, it is one of the last locally produced show making an impact and creating a shared cultural experience.
Yes. Alfred.
Silver, are you dyed?
You're right.
It is an educational show and I do not understand why people are making such a big deal out of it. And there's no doubt that a lot of students apply to schools like Presec, Mfantipim, Adisadel because of their interest in participating and possibly winning the National Science and Math Trophy to be part of something they know is much bigger than themselves. So for her to say this, she is essentially excluding the school from promoting science, technology, engineering and mathematics in Ghana and nurturing the next generation of innovators to make an impact on the world.
Hey.
And I don't understand why anybody would exclude themselves from that. But let's move on.
You see, in such schools, they have students that are biologically good.
Of course, they are gifted people.
They are biologically endowed with the knowledge. It's their field.
Nobody is born with knowledge. You have to acquire knowledge by working hard, being disciplined, and sacrificing a lot of time. So the idea that there are people endowed with knowledge it blows my mind.
Yes, it's not like the teachers that make them. So it's not somebody that forces them to do it. But then it's with them. They are born with it. But the school will not tell you such. The school will tell you that we have teachers that have prepared and trained our students for such courses.
But winning a competition has never only been about what you know or your capabilities. It's also about strategy, teamwork, and much more.
Amazing.
Before 2018, West African Senior High School had gone as far as the quarterfinals of the National Math and Science Quiz, which they achieved in 2017. But in 2018, they were able to make it to the finals, only losing by 1 point in a tiebreaker. And let me tell you this, the West African Senior High School is a Category B school. So what changed that season in 2018 was the addition of one coach who they got from Presbyterian Boys Secondary School, Legon. And that influenced their performance in the competition. Why is nobody talking about this? These big schools have been competing since the start of this show. So they have figured out different systems and stuck to the ones which work. But a lot of these newer schools only began competing recently and haven't figured out the strategies the big schools use. I think what she's saying might be a reflection of the system put in place in their school. It might be more of learning, solving questions, resolving questions, and not a lot of strategy to make you more effective and efficient. So they might learn a lot and still not be able to get into the further stages of the competition. So the school has been competing for a couple of years now, but have never been able to go past the preliminary stages of the competition. Presec has been in the finals of the National Science and Math Quiz for a record 12 times and have won the competition 8 times. So I'm going to make a case. We are going to take two people who are equally as smart and put them in very different situations. Person A and person B. These two people got the same mark in the BEC. And we all know after BEC, not everybody is going to get their first choice. You could be one of the best in your school and you still wouldn't get your first choice. So for these two people, one of them is admitted to a category A school and the other person is rejected and has to go to a category B school. But when these two people are competing in the NSMQ, we surely know who is favorite to win the competition and who is not getting anywhere near the trophy. Does the school automatically make one better than the other? Well, you can make a case for that. But it is also about the strategies and systems put in place by the category A school to help their good students win the competition. Yeah, so this really isn't about how much you know and obviously about the strategies that you are going to put in place to help your team win.
The school will tell you that we have teachers that have prepared and trained our students for such courses.
But it's true.
No, if that is true, then it means that GES is one, a biased and a failed institution. If they say all the teachers that they are giving out write an exam, write the test, then it means all teachers should be equal.
This is very ridiculous. Like, this particular part shouldn't make sense to anybody.
That's exactly what I'm trying to say.
Because we all write the same exam and we pass does not make us equal. It's not true. It will never be true. It's false. Let's move on.
Which school can you specifically point out and say that this school has won the science and math quiz 5 times in a row without pause? Like, they won this year, the next year they win, the following they win 5 times. Which school?
Yeah, I don't know if she watches any sports or has been involved in any competition. So what she just said actually goes in favor of the show and says a lot about how competitive these big schools are in that space. Imagine if one school just kept winning for 5 times in a row. Nobody would want that. There would be a lot of accusations about corruption and a whole lot of things. But the winner of the show changing every single year shows how difficult it is to maintain your position at the top and shows that these big schools are always improving their strategies and trying to be better. This is a testament to why everybody should be fluent and eloquent in English, because you could be saying the dumbest things and everybody will just forget about what you are saying. I just praise you because you speak so eloquently. So there was one part I didn't want to add, but when she says,
you see, when you put Ghana on the table, dissect its parts, open it up, you see that those people occupying big positions, they are the same people from those big institutions, and then they are the same people who steal, who are corrupt, stealing the money, stealing Ghana's money, building their own companies, and then they sit down and look for honest people to come and run it for them.
I actually had to look it up. And when I looked it up, I found 3 notable people who are apparently alumni of the school. These 3 people have worked in government. Out of the 3 people, it was just one who hadn't had a public controversy. 2 had been implicated in some corrupt activities that went on in the government. So I guess everybody has some skeletons in their closet. Yeah, so by final thoughts, it wasn't good. It wasn't good. When you sit down to actually think of it and you get access to some of the people who have competed in this competition, you know that a lot of what she is saying is just gibberish. The National Science and Math Quiz is doing everything it set out to do It is educating people. It is inspiring people. It is inspiring people to be better, to be faster, and to be more efficient when solving scientific problems. So if you liked and enjoyed the video, hit the thumbs up button. If you did not like the video, let me know in the comments and come and hit the like button, subscribe, and I'll see you another time. Bye-bye.